Welcome to the lecture series of pattern recognition, which is CS454 this semester for BTech. This is an elective subject for BTech final year CSE students. And my name is Shubhrendu Guhanyuge. I will be taking you through this particular subject, which is called pattern recognition. So basically, we need to know what is pattern recognition is. So pattern recognition machine learning is basically area where students learn how two different kinds of pattern are matched. For example, this is a pattern 1 and this is a pattern 2. Now whether this 1 and 2 are similar types of pattern, and the computer, the program, for example, you have a program, this is a C program, this will compare these two files and give output whether this is you can give a binary 0 or 1. 0 means okay, and these are not matching, and 1 means this is matching. So this is a very simple program of pattern recognition. Now in pattern recognition, we'll slowly learn how to create different kind of pattern. So whenever we study, we have something called statistical tools or statistical methods for comparing those patterns. So in this case, we'll be studying different models. So the first model what we are going to study is basically we are going to study Bayes' theorem. Before we start Bayes' theorem, we need to learn the basics of probability. And when we are studying the basics of probability, we need to have the basic understanding of probability. So we will start with the conditional probability. So conditional probability is one of the area where we study that when A happens before B or B happens before A, what happens. But before that, let's start with the basics of random variable. So what is random variable? So random variable is basically when we toss a coin. For example, this is a coin which is having either head or tail. Now if we toss a coin, so there is a probability of getting head is half, and probability of getting tail is half. Now in random variable, whenever we are working with random variable, we need to do some random experiment. For example, we are tossing a coin thrice. So basically we are going to toss the coin thrice. So tossing a coin 3 times. Now in this case there is no conditional probability, but there are certain cases where you can have conditional probability. Now tossing a coin 3 times, now random variable x is getting a value x. So what is x? This x means number of heads we get. Now let's find out the events if we toss a coin thrice. So basically we can calculate value of x, this small x, this capital X is the small x is a variable, capital X we are trying to calculate. So here in this case we'll be getting the value of x. So there can be event where we get all 3 times head. So if you are fortunate enough, you will be getting 3 heads, consecutive 3 heads. The first head you can get, second head you can get, and third time you can get tail also. So here in this case it will be 2. You can get head, tail, head also, or first time you get tail and then head also. Then the possibility is that you get three heads consecutive only once, but the possibility of getting head twice is more, number of occurrences is more, and the possibility of getting head once then tail and tail is one. And similar fashion you can have, you can get tail head tail tail head head, something like that. Okay, so getting head probability or possibility of getting head is again three times, because you can get head in the first attempt, head in the second attempt, head in the third attempt. So these are different kinds of combinations. Whenever we calculate probabilistic value, we need to take different kinds of combinations, and it may happen that we get head as zero. So in this case we can say that getting a value of x value can be, this is a small x, so x value can be 0 1 2 3. Okay, so this can be the value of x. Now in random variable we get two types of random variable. One is discrete and second is continuous. In both the cases we need to calculate in a different ways. Now let's first start with the discrete. So what is discrete random variable? Now if we calculate discrete random variable, so let's take x be discrete random variable, let's take DRV, discrete random variable which can take finite number of values. For example, x1, x2, x3, xn. Now, x greater than equal to xi. This is xi. This represent xi. Xj to xi. And also x less than xi. These are the different values or events. Now let's take an example. Coin tossed three times. X is again number of heads. So events, you can take the values, which is x equal to x, the values are 0, 1, 2, 3. So when x occurs 1, this is one case, TTD, but here in this case there will be three cases. We have already seen H, T, 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 H, T, and T, T, H. Appearing head twice, there will be only one, there will be again three cases, H, H, T, H, T, H, T, H, H, and three events, and the third one is head. Is the third case. Okay. So now x value will be always less than 3 for discrete random variable, because if we say that x equal to 4, this is not possible, not possible. So since this is not possible, then x can take a value of 0, 1, 2, 3. So x greater than or equal to 3. So we can calculate probability of x equal to 0, probability of x equal to 1, probability of x equal to 2, and probability of x equal to 3. So this is basically what we do, 1 by 8. So total number of events occurrence is 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2, 8. So total 8 events. In that 8 events, this is 1 by 8, this is 3 by 8, this is 3 by 8, and this is 1 by 8. Okay. So this is what random variable. Now next, we can find out what is probability mass function, PMF, probability mass function. So PMF of discrete random variable, okay, is something that lets x can take a value of xi, which is x1, x2, dot 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 xn. Now x be the discrete random variable which can take values of x2 x to the power n, x2 that's xi, that's x1 to xn. Now fx be a function, fx be function, okay, defined as set of real numbers. Now we can write fx equal to probability of x equal to xi if for I value of 1 to n and 0 otherwise. So this is called probability mass function. So fx is PMF, probability mass function, for random variable x, which represent x to x to I, then we can say p of x comma xi is pi. Similarly, okay, we can take x p up p1 to pn. So we can define p1 to pn in this particular fashion. Okay, then we can find out the value of fx in case of probability mass function. So next we can calculate the probability distribution function, PDF. So what is PDF? The probability, next we calculate PDF probability, okay, distribution function. So probability distribution function, let's x be random variable. Now capital fx is PDF if fx is defined as fx equal to probability x, this is capital X less than small x. Okay, and we can also call it as cumulative distribution function. So we can compute by using different formula, okay, for this value of probability distribution function and probability mass function. Okay, thank you for listening.